Welcome to another edition of VPN Test Drive, brought to you by VPNTop10.com. Today we're going to show you how to use uTorrent anonymously. uTorrent, as you know, is one of the most popular BitTorrent clients in the world. But some people probably don't want their IP addresses publicly broadcast to anyone with an internet connection. We'll show you what we mean. This is a peer list for a file we were downloading in uTorrent. You can easily access this by clicking on the torrent file and then clicking on the peer tab below. As you can see, it shows the full IP address of everybody that's involved in the torrent swarm at this moment. Now we've blurred out the last digits of the IP addresses for privacy, but you can see what we mean. Now this was a fully legal torrent that was distributed under the Creative Commons license, but even so, you probably wouldn't want your IP address being broadcast to a bunch of strangers. That's why you use a proxy or a VPN service, because the IP address that appears in the swarm is not your own, it's the IP of the proxy or VPN service's server. There are two different tools you can use to stay anonymous on uTorrent, a VPN and a proxy. Though they both accomplish similar things, they each work a little bit differently, so we're going to look at them one by one. The tool that you're probably the most familiar with is a VPN, or Virtual Private Network. Nowadays, this is a simple one-click solution where you basically select whichever server you want to connect to from the software, and then click Connect. This will wrap your entire internet connection in a protected VPN tunnel, and route all your data through a third-party server. When you do this, your torrent traffic and your web traffic will all originate from the same IP address, the IP address of the VPN server. A proxy works a little bit differently. Instead of routing all of your internet traffic through a third-party server, it just lets you route one program or protocol through the server. In this case, your uTorrent traffic. This is actually pretty useful. A lot of BitTorrent users want to route their torrent traffic through a server in a country like the Netherlands or Romania, but there's a lot of reasons why you wouldn't want your web browser going through that country. You don't want Google results from Romania, and you probably still want access to your streaming services like Netflix, Hulu, and Pandora, which would be geo-blocked in other countries. Another major difference between VPNs and proxies is that all VPNs by definition encrypt your data in transit. Most proxy servers do not offer encryption. Encryption is what prevents your internet provider from reading your traffic and slowing down your BitTorrent downloads. Fortunately, uTorrent actually has a built-in feature that lets you encrypt your proxy connections quickly and easily. We're going to show you how to do it when we go into our full uTorrent setup. Let's do it now. Now, before you can set up uTorrent to be used anonymously, it's critical that you have a tool that will let you test whether your anonymization settings are working and will show you your IP address from the viewpoint of the uTorrent client. Fortunately, there's a great tool brought to you by a company called TorGuard that we can download now. It's free. You can get it by going to vpntop10.com/checkip, and then you scroll to the bottom and click on Check Your Torrent IP. And all we have to do is download this little tool. It's basically, we're going to open it with uTorrent here. It's just a torrent file. And if we go into our downloads here and you go to trackers, it will show you your current IP address right here from the perspective of the uTorrent client. All right, so let's set up a proxy. You have to go to the options menu and then preferences. So you can just hit Control P. And you want to go to the connections tab right here. For our proxy service today, we're going to be using Private Internet Access. We're a big fan of them for uTorrent for a couple reasons. First of all, they don't keep any logs and they allow torrents on all servers. And if you buy their VPN service for $40 per year, they throw in free proxy service for free. You can check them out by going to vpntop10.com/PIA. We'll have the link up there. Or just by visiting the website directly. Okay, let's start in this top section here. These are our recommended settings. We would recommend you keep everything checked except enable UPnP. The reason is that there's a security flaw that hasn't been fixed in a lot of routers except the ones that have come out this year. So better safe than sorry, leave that one unchecked unless things aren't working. Okay, let's set our proxy server. You're gonna select your proxy server type and it's gonna be SOX5. And the address here for private internet access is proxy-nl.privateinternetaccess.com. The port is 1080. Okay. The next step is getting your username and password. And this is basically what you're going to see right here when you first open it for the first time. to get your username and password. It's not the same as your VPN password with privateinternetaccess.com. You actually have to go into your client panel, and if you scroll to the bottom here, there's going to be this little tool that lets you click a button and you can generate a new username and password, and this is the password that you use for your proxy service, and that's what you put in the uTorrent. Okay, so we've got our username and a password in, and then you want to check all these boxes. This one is saying yes, I know that, or it tells uTorrent that there's a username and password for it, and the rest of them tell uTorrent to use the proxy for all relevant queries made by the uTorrent client, just to make sure that no communication is taking outside the proxy tunnel. You want everything to go through the proxy so that you're anonymous all the time. Okay, we hit apply, and then the one other thing that you want to do is you want to go to the BitTorrent tab, and you want under protocol encryption, you want to change the outgoing protocol encryption to forced to make sure that all the traffic that's going through this proxy tunnel is wrapped in an encrypted tunnel. The benefit of that is it prevents your ISP from reading your traffic and seeing what you're downloading, and possibly throttling and slowing down your torrent traffic. Okay, and then we recommend you uncheck allow incoming legacy connections, just to make sure that you don't allow any insecure connections that have already been going. Click apply, and then we'll go down here, and then we can force this little tool to update here. So we're gonna hit update tracker, and give it a sec. You can see their IP address here has changed. That shows that our proxy server is now working. Awesome. You can see that's our web browser IP address, and that's our torrent IP address. Now, if you want added security, you can actually run the proxy inside a VPN tunnel. So you have the proxy inside the VPN. Your browser web address will be changed from your normal IP, and the proxy address, or the uTorrent IP address, will be different than your VPN address. So just to show you how that works, we're gonna connect to a server in, let's see, the west coast of the USA. And we'll give it a second to connect here. IP Monkey, hit refresh. As you can see, our IP address has changed again. It's the IP address of our browser, and we'll go back here and we're going to update the proxy tracker. Sometimes it has issues when you keep jumping around your web address. And as you can see, our proxy address stayed the same and is still different than our VPN address, and both of them are different than our original IP address. So you got a tunnel inside a tunnel, both anonymous. Very cool. Okay, now we're going to deactivate the proxy for a second, and we're going to talk more about using just a VPN. All right, now we're gonna talk a little bit about using a VPN with uTorrent instead of a proxy, although I always recommend using them together. The first thing you're gonna notice is this little system tray icon down here. I love how it provides a visual indicator of your connection status with private internet access. If you disconnect, it just turns red. So you can always see visually where you're at. Okay, we're gonna go into the settings, and I wanna show you a couple important settings. Most of this stuff is pretty simple. We're going to go to the connection settings. Port forwarding is an option. If you're having speed issues, you can try enabling port forwarding and setting it up through your router, but that's a different video. But these three settings are critical. I recommend always having these two checked, especially DNS leak protection. That makes sure that when you do, like, look up the web address of a, like when you type in a web address like google.com and it looks up for where that server is located, if you don't have this checked in Windows, sometimes it will route that lookup outside your VPN tunnel, which could expose your true IP address without your knowledge, which you don't want to do. Always keep this one checked. IPv6, keep it checked. The VPN kill switch is really useful if you're not using a proxy with uTorrent. And the reason is that if your VPN connection drops ordinarily, uTorrent will just try to reconnect through your normal internet connection that isn't protected by a VPN. If you enable the kill switch, this will instantly kill your internet connection so that uTorrent can't reconnect through your normal connection. So, extra safety feature, good to have. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching this video. I just want to remind you of a couple key points that we made during the video. First off, I really like using a proxy for uTorrent because it lets you have a different IP address than your web browser, which I think is really useful. The second point to remember is that a VPN has much stronger encryption than a proxy, even when using the encryption function built into uTorrent. So if encryption is important to you or you're having slow speeds because your ISP is throttling you, you should add a VPN. They're better if used together. Adds a greater layer of privacy, a second layer of privacy. And the other thing to remember is that if you're not using a proxy, always use a VPN kill switch with uTorrent to make sure that your true IP address isn't exposed by accident if the VPN disconnects. Remember, you can get private internet access, VPN, and proxy in one. Both services included, both can be used simultaneously, and it's only $40 a year, or $3.33 per month. You can get that by going to vpntop10.com/PIA. That is an affiliate link. We'll get a small commission, and of course, you will get a great VPN service at the best possible price. Thanks a lot. Check you later.